Hello there, everybody, and welcome back to falmunction plays Dark Souls 3. Funnily enough, when I noticed this bonfire here and I went back to get my souls and level up, I saw that these untended graves show up in the Cemetery of Ash category here, which is very interesting how the game loops in on itself here. Was not expecting that. Now, obviously this is not the tutorial anymore. This is what I've been told endgame content. People are fighting here as well. I was surprised by some of the enemies here that are still, yeah, these guys showing up. Let's see, actually, is there, they already, yeah, they noticed me. Let's just move along to this side first, because I think we've seen all there is to see on the other side with the birdies. Now, there's this guy. Sneaky bugger who, I guess there's. Man. Jesus Christ. This ambush is all over the place. Jesus. Man. At least they give me Titanite chunks, right? Speaking of which. Alright. The game's telling us this is getting near endgame content. So we should be wary here. The dogs are chilling over there. Oh, there's three of them. Three dog! Ow! Are you gonna come over here? Yeah. Good boy. It gave me a lot of trouble last time. There's another one of you! Well, that's just peachy. I was hoping for a backstab there, but gotta be careful. Like that. Whew. Alright. What you got here? Another chunk. And even more dogs around the corner, it seems. Yeah. Okay. Well, let me heal up real quick. Continue on here. Could this be? It seems familiar. Pull back. I wonder what it could be. Like, this reminds me of the time I, let that be dark. Yeah, there's another Titanite lizard. It is a mirror image of the. There are two of them. It is a. Wait. Did you see that? There's this black shimmer What the hell? Do I have like a black aura or something? That's weird. Okay. Let's be smart here. I'll go there as soon as I'm done exploring the rest of the place. They went down fast. Okay, I'll have another visit with the crow ladies. Just to make sure I didn't miss anything there. Ouch. Get the hell away from me. Yes! That's what I was thinking was gonna happen. Man, oh man. This is not an easy area. Okay, at least now we got all our Estus back. Oh, the other ones weren't even activated. Because it doesn't scream. Okay. What are you praying for here? Whenever I see you guys, you're praying for something. You're not actually hostile until somebody rattles you up. Hmm. Okay, I'm gonna at least try to fight those, I think they're called Grave Wardens, actually, the fast ones. I'm gonna try and fight them. Actually, maybe Pyromancer might be better. To keep some of my Estus. Although I could also just try and avoid them, maybe? Like this? Just listen for the footsteps. In case they're... Oh! I think I avoided, I avoided them all, and I ran past the part with the Titanite. The Titanite lizards. And here's where we would have seen our first bonfire in the tutorial area. Interesting. What the hell? Well, you know who would be my boss character here? If I was the game designer, right? This is a jumping tutorial. And there is an item, but there's... the item is next to the... next to the, sarcophagus. What down here? Mm-hmm. I was just trying not to get shoved off the cliff. It used to be another item here. Not this time, though. Very interesting. Very interesting indeed. And this... We're in total nothingness here. There's no filing shrine at a distance, at least it doesn't look like it. Hey! Stop it. No! I was trying to shield with... God damn it! Okay. Well. At least now it's safe to get the item over there. Wrong way. Because I do wonder, would I go further? Would there be a boss? Probably yes. Probably a mirror image. Hey! I didn't see you. It must have been feigning death over there. Okay. Well then, let's see what we got in store for us. I knew it. And the door is closed. That's interesting. Black Knight Glaive. Wasn't that... Didn't it used to be the halberd? Glaive of the Black Knights who wander the lands, used to face chaos demons. The unique attack of this glaive greatly reduces enemy poise, reflecting the tremendous size of the enemy that the knights have fearlessly faced. Spin sweep. In case you watched my Dark Souls 2 playthrough, most of my playthrough I was playing with this weapon, I think. But it was the Black Knight Halberd back then. Oh! He doesn't even wait for me to get his sword or something. Okay. So... Champion Gunger is his name. He's got some new moves, it seems. His reach is still the same ridiculous length here. I do remember, actually, I think I would have I wouldn't have had to waste so many tries on the first one had I blocked a little more. But I also maybe should try some pyromancy now. I don't actually know if he's weak to that. But actually, wait. Gotta get used to this guy. That move is really pissing me off. I might not do this the first try. I hope you excuse me there. Hmm. Oh, we'll see. We'll see. Getting back into the groove. Okay, I see. I see now. Red eyes don't usually mean good things. Alright. We'll try again with pyromancy. We'll see. So, as with any boss, say it with me now, the most important thing is to find a way back to it that's both fast and safe, preferably. So I think we should be able to do this. Uh-oh. The guy's still following me. Well, we'll see. Oh! Somebody just fell to its death. Okay, okay. Gonna activate pretty much everybody. Oh. I guess they're just gonna let me through them. That's fine. So, let's try out pyromancy then. I should not have done that right away. Wait your chance. Okay, 500 damage is pretty good. Oh dear. Oh, come on. Here we go, second phase. He's probably gonna have another one after that. He turns into a fierce snake monster. Ouch. Out of stamina. Shit. Oh dear. Fuck. Okay. Where's the snake? No snake this time? Shit. Held my shield up in the nick of time. Okay. And that was it. Air of Fire destroyed. Soul of Champion Gunder. Alright. Very nice. Champion Gunder. Udix Gunder, Champion Gunder. Oh boy. So yeah, maybe this is the Abyss after all. The Abyss, in case you don't know, is where, well, basically it represents what happens when the fire in the world goes out, and it's usually where the bad guys come from, literally. All the villains of Dark Souls. Okay. Let's have at it. Darkfowling Shrine or something? What the hell? Well, can't see shit. No way. This is eerily familiar. Not just because this is another mirror image, but also it reminds me of the kiln of the first flame. But this can't be it. This can't be the end of the game, right? They wouldn't hide the end of the game behind Oh, wait. For a second I thought it was another Oh, there is another Black Knight! Damn it! Let's retreat to a safer place. You guys coming? Oh, yes you are. Oh, no. Well, if that's the case, ooh, you don't like that, huh? Okay, I think that's enough, so I can fight them one on one. Alright, Black Knight Helm. What do you have to say, Black Knight Helm? We got a Silver Knight once. Armor of the Black Knights who roamed the lands. The knight served the First Lord Gwyn and followed him into the flame upon its linking. They became ash, but still wander the realms to this day. And the Silver Knights, it is said that even after the family's passing, the knights continued to watch over their manor and the ruined cathedral. Yeah. One of them, like one battalion or whatever, stayed home. The other went with him. Any more of you? Yeah, this looks like another filing shrine. What the hell? I don't want to go in case there's another boss or something. I want to see what else we can find here. There's another Black Knight and another item. Just no backstabs for me today. Oh, never mind. Ouch. Still hitting like a truck, but we've gotten pretty strong too in the meantime, since I faced the first one of you in this game. Okay. Will there be another master? No. But we got a Chaos Blade in here. Is this open? Nah. We don't even get a choice to see if it's closed, which means we're probably never gonna be able to open it. But that's fine, that's fine. I'm eager to go in there, but you guys should know me by now. Another crestfallen knight soul. There's another one. Okay. Well then, have at you. Don't toss me off the cliff, please. He kind of was like, hey, looks like you want to backstab me, let me help you with that. But also, let me kill you if you can. Oh shit! Thank you, Gravestone. Greatly appreciate that. God. There we go. Whew. And this is Hawkwood's grave. What you got for me, Hawkwood? The Hornet Ring. I guess we didn't have that yet. Yeah. So, this is the ring associated with Lord's Blade. Karen? Kieran? I always heard her name Karen, but maybe this is a misprint, I don't know. I remember her name being spelled C-A-I-R-A-N, but who knows. One of the four knights of Gwyn, the First Lord, boosts critical attacks. Masked Karen was the only woman to serve in Gwyn's four knights, and her curved sword granted a swift death to any and all enemies of the throne. Karen was sort of a rogue type character. With lots of, well, two daggers actually. Just two. Man. Okay. There's no going around it. Filing shrine. Very ominous, I gotta say. There are sunlights, though. Coiled sword fragment. So, are we in the past then? All the thrones are still empty. The fire is not yet lit. Are there names inscribed in the thrones yet? Yes. What do we got here? It's still Holy King Lothric. This is wild. Oh. You're still here. Or should I say already?
Well, fancy that. A lost lamb wandereth in with nary a peep from the bell. Well, thou shouldst my purpose know. What can this old handmaid provide thee?
I was always, look, let that be known. I was always suspicious of this old woman.
To skirt the curse's grasp, tarry not for long. 'Tis dark for now, and not a soul stirs. But remember, fires are known to fade in quiet. Or perhaps thou'rt captive already, like the poor girl.
Hmm.
To skirt the tatties all like...
Fucking creepy lass. Okay. Look at that. Priestess ring. A ring engraved with a portrait of the High Priestess increases faith. Is she the High Priestess? In Lothric, the High Priestess has long been considered one of the three pillars of the king's rule. The High Priestess also served as the king's wet nurse. I don't know. I don't know about that. And this, actually, it says Wolf Knight helm. And armor and gauntlets and leggings. But it's actually... I can't believe I'm blanking on the name. It's fucking Artorias is set. Sorry guys, it's late. I actually got a headache. So here, helm of a knight tainted by the dark of the abyss. The twilight blue tassel is damp and will ever remain so. A vanquished knight left behind only wolf's blood and his legacy of duty. The undead legion of Farron was formed to bear his torch, and the armor of these abyss watchers suggests their own eventual end. Yeah. Artorias is a very interesting...
Best not tarry long.
Artorias' tale is very, very interesting, but I think it would... not be really what we need right now. So nobody's here, as there should or shouldn't. But it bears checking. What's this? Hollow's ashes. Umbral ash of a hollow who faithfully served a woman only to become separated from her. With this, the shrine maid will prepare new items. It takes but a brief glance at this thing to easily envision Londor, the foreboding land of hollows. That's interesting. Like, shouldn't we... This was the place where, what's his name died? I forgot his name. Give me a break. We haven't talked to him in ages because he died. it'll come back to me. I'm pretty sure. So, if we give it to her... I'd rather give it to the other handmaid, just in case... You know, just in case we might not be able to access it afterward. If I'm wrong about all this and, yeah. And there's nothing else here, then I apologize, but I just gotta be sure. Okay. Man. Okay, look. Let's have a look at this coiled sword fragment. Fragment of the coiled sword of a bonfire which served its purpose long ago. Returns caster to last bonfire used for resting or to the bonfire enfiling shrine can be used repeatedly. Ah! Bonfires are linked to one another irreversibly, retaining their affinity long after their purpose is exhausted. This is actually not something to be used, to make a bonfire, but actually it's to be used like this miracle. See? So basically it opened up one more spell slot for me, which is cool. There was another item like that in Dark Souls 2, which you got late in the game, that let you go to any bonfires whenever you wanted.
Well, thou art exceeding what can... To skirt hat is all like... Best not...
The girl... Honestly... I don't know. I think I've seen everything. I've been told there was something that would open up another area for me, and it was so obscure that I would never be able to find it. Never be able to guess where it is. And it seems that is the case. Like, remember the assassin I ran into? That probably saved Henri's life? Can't even go in here. That, he said, was a lot less cryptic than what I'm actually looking for. So, whatever. I'm just gonna go back to the bonfire and maybe the people there can show me something. I don't know. So we're back. None the wiser.
Well met. How?
She is none the wiser as well. Let's give her these ashes.
Passing fine, let I only.
Okay, what do we got here? Oh. We can buy Gundyr's stuff now. Ancient helm of a set of cast iron armor belonging to champion Gundyr, modeled after a former king. Gundyr, or the belated champion, was bested by an unknown warrior. He then became sheathed to a coiled sword in the hopes that someday the first flame would be linked once more. Huh. Interesting. I guess that's all we get. Well, that's fine. Okay.
Ashen one, beat one.
I'm just gonna go talk to everybody.
Tis good to what needs me.
Maybe he can.
There are two ways to see.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks. I thought maybe he saw that I had his smith hammer. Actually, we didn't really read up on it. Where is it? Isn't it in... Yeah, it's in weapons. Metal hammer passed down amongst blacksmiths of the shrine. Serves as a strike weapon, but also excels at reducing poise and breaking the guard of a shield. Of course, the hammer's true potential is realized in the hands of a blacksmith. Nothing really out of the ordinary there. We haven't talked to our maiden in a long time.
Oh, champion of Ash, do you wish to hear it? You know, in my home of Adwood, it is terrible.
Okay. I think actually, well, I can't get the, I guess I never bought this, terrible tomb or whatever from the... From Yuria, or whatever her name was. The girl who was trying to get a... to get me on the throne as King of Hollows or something. But now that she's gone...
Now in Bandcom.
I guess we're never gonna...
Aha,
further that quest line, I guess.
Ah. Fine kindling for the thrones, is it not? And all slain by... Oh, In fact, we...
Okay.
Now, now.
We didn't actually have a look at the Gunder soul, so let's see what that tells us. Used to acquire, blah, blah. Once a champion came late to the festivities and was greeted by a shrine without fire and a bell that would not toll. Got that right.
Aha.
Okay. Soul of Champion Gunder gives me the prisoner's chains. Portion of a steel chain used to restrain Gunder. Gain vigor, endurance, and vitality, but take extra damage. A prisoner is one who has staked everything on a belief, a proclivity most apparent in the greatest of champions. Or Gunder's halberd. This old cast iron halberd has the power to break poison and is said to never crumble, seeming to suggest that Gunder was fated to eternal service from the beginning. He's got a champion charge, which I don't think anything else has. Oh, and I never actually had a look at this. This is what the soul of Osiris gives us. Not very surprisingly, in fact. A legendary dragon weapon associated with Seath the Pale Drake. Charge strong attack to limit to its limit to unleash Moonlight Wave. Osiris, the consumed king, was infatuated with the search for Moonlight, but in the end, it never revealed itself to him. Moonlight Vortex. Or White Dragon Breath, sorcery of the deluded consumed king Osiris. Crystal Breath of Seath. The scaleless crystal breath has piercing capabilities. Seath's research seemed to strike a chord with old Big Head, who in his mad, disrobed state made divine work such as this his own. Osiris was no doubt edified by this. So Osiris was also studying the works of Big Head Logan, was also driven mad. Okay, everything else we don't have. Interesting. Okay. You have anything
welcome
to tell me?
Home, Ashen One. Speak thine. Ashen One, may I pose thee a question?
What?
Has the little Lord Ludlith spoken to thee of any curious matters?
Hold on.
I sense that he possesseth some knowledge of a thing once most precious or most terrible, now lost to the firekeepers. Pray tell, is it a matter of which I should be apprised?
Okay, well, I don't get to make a decision here, but...
Ashen One, may I have this offering?
Maybe now we can talk to Ludlith some more. What's the deal, Luddy?
Aha. Ah, most illustrious Lord Seeker.
No.
And, oh, in fact.
Still has the same dialogue. That's weird. Oh, man, I'm actually a little bit... I don't know, I'm a little bit at a loss here.
Ah, yes. There is one thing that you should know. There is a darkness.
Yeah.
Do stay...
Heed my words, fear the whole undertow.
Yeah, we got that too. What about you? I guess I could give him the Logan scroll, but then again, fuck it.
Oh my, you've made quite the discovery. This is a scroll of the prodigious Big Hat Logan, a masterful sorcerer, long missed in Minheim. And now we have his scroll, right here in my very hands.
How about thanks, maybe? Okay, we got Homie Soul Mass, Soul Spear. I guess Soul Greatsword we didn't have before. And that's it. It's not really blowing the doors off, I think.
I don't mean to seem overbearing, but have in exchange for my...
Dude!
Scroll, I hope you're not...
Chill out. I just gave you, like, the scroll of one of the biggest sorcerers in history, so... I don't know what else to tell you. Okay, so I think we only have, what's his name left? Wrong way. Patches to talk to. And I do think we must have messed up with Grey Rat at some point. I don't think they would have us, you know, wait this long until his questline was resolved.
Oh, hello again. Go. We're just a couple of outcasts.
Great. Come. So I guess that's it, huh? I guess, well, I mean, maybe there's something more outside here? Could we maybe do something here that could, affect what's happening in the past? I don't know. It's all very strange. Very strange indeed. I don't see any items anywhere around here, so... I guess that's gonna be it for this episode. You know... I gotta be honest, I might have to consult a friend. Like, Token might... Well, he's actually pretty eager to give me some hints at this point. But there is a place where we haven't checked yet. Where we went off at the High Wall of Lothric. We went off to the left to fight Osiris. But there was another path with lots of... Lothric Knights that were kicking the shit out of me. So I guess I'll go there first and see what I can find there. Until then, thanks for watching. And I'll see you when we do that I just told you. Goodbye.